Welcome to Bitbender Studio. Today we're going to be talking about how to bill as a DJ, you know, how to present those invoices to your clients without shooting yourself on the foot. We'll be right back. Welcome back. Yeah, like I said earlier, you need to know how to bill as a DJ. I noticed that a lot of DJs out there now, maybe like the upcoming DJs, they basically just throw in bills at their clients without asking for, you know, without taking recognizance or asking a lot of questions. They just go ahead and bill their clients and they end up shooting themselves on the foot. Just, you know, some couple of peanuts to get by. The bottom line is what you need to understand, your equipment are very expensive. You have trained yourself and you've been under a particular tutor, you know, teacher, and now your time is important to you as well. And then every other thing that does not belong to you, that you're going to be getting on the third party side, you have to bill for all of this. So this is how it's going to work. The best way to bill your clients. Let's talk about it. Number one, consider your equipment. Like I said earlier, your equipment are expensive, and the moment you start using your equipment, trust me, every day you take them out, the value depreciates, the worth depreciates, and in terms of performance and efficiency, there's a little bit that is cut off from it. Either maybe one of your knob, continuous turn of your knob, at a point in time it's either gonna pull off or just stop working. Your faders, your aesthetics and the cosmetics, they're gonna start wearing out one by one as you start taking out your equipment. So if you think, oh yeah, I already have bought my equipment and because of that I can go ahead and bill any price, bro, the day that equipment develops a fault or the day the equipment packs up, will you be able to afford another one? That's what we're talking about. So always factor the cost of your equipment in any event you are going to. So I'm going out to go and perform at an event. I put it there, my equipment, let's say for example 50,000. I'm just in an example for my equipment. So for me to bring in my equipment, maybe 50,000. It depends now. If I'm going to be talking about the speakers I'll be coming with and the mixer, it now depends on the venue. Some of you DJs out there, you don't go out to perform reconnaissance. You don't know the venue that you are going to use for the event. You've not been there before. You don't have a picture of the environment. They just tell you, can you come and play for us at a wedding? You say, oh yeah, where's the venue? They give you the address. I say, okay, we are coming. My bill is 200,000. You now get to the venue and realize that it's a 1,000 seater capacity and you need multiple speakers, multiple mixers and all that to get everything, the amplifiers, you need multiple amplifiers to get everything working in perfect condition. So how do you do that? Now you are stuck. You have to make sure you pay extra to get those equipment. So it's better to always get your equipment right in terms of venue. Know the capacity of people that will be in that particular venue so that you can know the kind of speakers and the amplifiers to bring in. With that in mind, that's what will help me to know, okay, this is how much I'm going to bill you totally on the equipment in terms of, yeah, the speakers I'll be bringing in and all the mixers and all that and the subs and the tops and all that. So basically, you need to know the venue so that you can actually know how much to bill on the equipment. That's just one. Talking about the people that are going to be working with you, your technical crew, also very, very important that you get good technical crew to come and work with you, and those don't come free as well. You should be able to say, you know what, this is how much I'm going to bill for the people that will be coming to assist in working with me, like either moving the speakers and, you know, laying the cables and all that. You need to put that their bill separately, just in case they say, you know what, don't worry, we have someone that can carry everything for you. You say, okay, fine, let's take that out. But if you don't have anybody that can do that for me, I'm bringing in my crew or my team, and this is how much this is how much it's going to cost you for that particular service. Now let's talk about power, which is another important thing. I've been to places where they present them, the event managers or the event owner will start asking you, why didn't you come with power? And you'll be like, no, I'm a DJ, I'm not NEPA. So why not just try to let it be stated clearly before you even sign that deal or before you agree to that contract? Ask them, please, am I coming with power? Or will power be provided in that venue? If they tell you, don't worry, we have power covered, don't bother. But the moment they start telling you, no, you have to come with like a backup power, which simply means in Nigeria, generator. Bro, 6. Bill for the power separately. Like if I'm coming with power, this is how much it's going to cost. Because I'm bringing in a generator, a standby generator that's going to feed me, if not possible, even your hall. But this is how much it's going to cost you. Put that separately. Then you go, okay, so now we've taken care of all those things. You can now start saying, you know, my service charge. This is how much I'm going to bill you for the work I am coming to do. Because a DJ, you might just be called and say, you know what, we have everything is in place at this venue or this event. We have the mixer, we have the amplifier, we have speakers, we have everything. Don't put that, just come and play. So you also need a price to put on yourself. You need a price tag. So for me, it is how much are you going to pay me? This is my own billing for every hour. Bill hourly. This is why it's important for you to bill, learn to bill hourly. If you bill hourly, you'll be able to say, you know what, for the first 4 hours, let me give you an example. I'm playing at a birthday for you. Okay, fine. My service charge, let's say I've covered the equipment, tech crew, and I've covered we're still coming to transportation, don't worry. I've covered equipment, tech crew, and I've covered maybe the sound and all that. So now let's talk about my own billing. Let's say I'm billing you 200,000 naira, and I say that 200,000 naira covers just 3 hours. If you extend per each hour, you are paying me 50,000 naira. It is that simple. So let's just say, if you extend more than 1 hour, for every hour I'm staying there extra, you are paying me 50,000 naira extra. So you don't have to waste my time. When it's time for me to go, I go. If you don't want me to go, you have to pay more to make me stay. That is at least reasonable on, an entry level when you are trying to go out there and bid for job. Don't just go there and they call you, okay, fine, we have an event. How much are you going to charge us? And you go, is it a wedding? Okay, 100K. And the person is happy and the person, and you know how these people do lately. They still bargain that 100K for you with you and drag it back and forth. You later succumb to 50K. Oh my God. Then you get to the event and realize that, wait, the amount you are spending on the equipment, the amount you are spending on the speakers and all those things, they've already eaten up all those money. Then let's talk about transportation. Transportation is the last thing you want to build based on every other findings. Let me give you an example. If they say, don't worry, the venue already has sound, you just come with your mixer and we plug it in, transportation will be cheaper. But if they say, bros, you are coming with your speaker, you are coming with your amplifier, you are coming with your mixer, transportation goes a bit higher. And they go, oh, see, you're even coming with your power, you're bringing your generator, transportation goes higher. Because while this device, this mixer can fit in a car, speakers cannot fit in a car. If you are coming with, for a good example, 2 tops and 2 subs, they can fit perfectly in a car. We are talking about me like getting a Sienna or getting a bus. And then now we are talking about, you know what, we need, this is a very large event, we need like about four speakers, 4 tops, 4 subs, and then we need you to come with power. You know, definitely you are talking of a truck already. And that truck costs more than the other ones. So those are some of the things you need to look into before you just go out there and open your mouth as a DJ and say, this is how much I'm charging. You get there, shoot yourself on the foot. Always ask, do a reconnaissance, like I said earlier. Ask for the venue. Where are they using? How many seats are capacity? Don't live by their words of mouth. Try to say, send me a picture. Send me a picture. And you tell them, this is the amount of speaker that we can use that will make the sound work perfectly okay here. And this is how much the sound is going to cost you in terms of this equipment. It's simple. That's basically what we're looking at. Also, bill on every other thing I've just mentioned earlier. Take care of your transportation, take care of your technical crew, take care of your sound, that is your equipment, and then your own service charge, how much you are worth on an hourly basis. Give them a discount on the first 3 or 4 hours, and then subsequent hour, this is how much it's going to cost you. Let them know that, send that out in a written format, soft copy or hard copy, send it to them, let them know and agree to it before you receive that alert. And that's how you don't shoot yourself on the foot. Because there's a lot of DJs out there now going out there just billing anyhow and collecting peanuts. You just give me 20K, give me 30K. That's why some professional DJs out there are being approached with some mediocre prices. That but someone wants to do it for me for 20K. No, go and meet the person how to do it for 20K. Because all they will come to you, all they come to your off to your event with is maybe like a virtual DJ, their laptop and one mixer, and then connect. But if you really need a seasoned DJ to work for you, someone who has actually paid his dues and has spent, you know, sweat and blood to secure all this equipment that we're talking about here. Then the person knows the value of what you are about to get, and that's why all these things need to be put properly in place. So if I'm billing you for equipment, billing you for all of that, I have a place where I put back a reasonable amount of that money that goes for the equipment. I should be able to say at a point, yes, I have been able to make back the money I used to buy this equipment and then saved up somewhere, just in case anything happened, or just in case I'm thinking of, you know, an upgrade. Then I can sell this off and pick another one without stress. That'll be all for now. It's been the studio. Remember how to bill as a DJ properly without shooting yourself on the foot. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share, and we'll see you in the next one.